Pushbacks and forwards. Pushbacks and forwards. Loosening it up. All right, one more time. This time hold back. Coming on forward, all the way down. We're going to push ourselves up and back into that plank. Yep, he heard the word plank. He knows what's going to happen. 3, 2, 1, up, back. Draw the shoulders back. Today is Genesis 17, 19. Then God said, yes, but your wife Sarah will bear you a son, and you will call him Isaac. I will establish my covenant with him as an everlasting covenant for his descendants after him. Genesis 17, 19. This is one of the earliest prophecies of Jesus. I chose it because it mentioned Isaac, which means laughter, who is just like my youngest son named Isaac, who brings much laughter. Earlier in this verse, the very thought of Abraham and his postmenopausal wife Sarah having a baby made them both laugh. Yet, through this very unlikely scenario, God foreshadowed another seemingly far-fetched situation that produced Jesus as the promised everlasting covenant for Isaac's descendants, God's people, the Israelites. Hundreds of years later, Paul wrote in Romans 9:7-8 that the adopted Gentile children of the promise, you and me, are now regarded as Isaac's descendants, aka God's people. And in Christ, we are truly God's sons and daughters with a spiritual lineage dating back to Isaac. We're every bit the children of God, but just as Isaac was the child of Abraham and Sarah, and Jesus himself was a child of Mary and Joseph. My Woman's Bible group recently studied Paul's letter to the Ephesians. In it, Paul repeatedly prays that we understand the glorious riches of our spiritual inheritance through the promised Messiah, Jesus, which was first foreshadowed to the faithful old couple more than 25 years ago. Faith step. Ponder your glorious spiritual inheritance by praying for yourself. Read Ephesians 1:15-20, 3:14-21. Have a cat lay on your book while you're trying to read too. It's really good. All right, buddy. Okay. So, God has given us so many riches and glorious things. We need to remember to pray, thank Him for all He's done, through all, everything, even when you're faced with troubles. Take your prayers to the Lord, but always remember to thank Him for everything He's done and for pulling you through the most tragic situations and blessing you with such beautiful memories and blessings. You don't need to enter me. He looks like he was going to hit me. He says, lady, don't do that to me. All right, let's see what our motivation is today. It helps if I go to the right button. This direction. There we go. Draw the shoulders back. Progress lies not in enhancing what is, but in advancing towards what will be. Are you stuck in a rut just doing the same thing over and over again? Or are you making a plan to make changes in your life towards what your goals are and what things can be? Okay. Progress promise lies not in enhancing what is, but advancing towards what will be. Kitty cat, you're driving me crazy. Progress lies not in enhancing what is, but in progressing in what can be. It didn't get hairy one bit. Not in enhancing what is. See what it says. Stay to the side and stretch if you need to, or stay in that solid plank if you can. You do what your body can do, and you work through it. It means that any enhancement made today with reference to future needs will lead to progress while blindly doing work on our present. Let's see if this will tell me the whole thing when I click on it. Sometimes when you click on it, you can't find what it's talking about. Which is pretty much what I was saying. This is just one of the interpretations, though, obviously. History problem, all these different second perspectives, and are you doing what you can just to make it by? Are you doing what you can to better yourself for your future and for your family? Progress lies not in enhancing what is, just to stay where you are, making it just stay the same, but in advancing towards what will be, making a difference, progressing forward to achieve your goals and to better your future for you and your family. Take it up. Draw the shoulders back. Take it in. Think about all the amazing things the Lord has done for you. Take a moment. Pray for yourself for guidance. As you go through your day and as you plan for your next year, don't plan just to stay where you are and enhance it, but make a plan to make a step forward, to achieve higher results, to work towards your goals. Three, two, one. Push back. You are amazing, and don't forget it.